Welcome back to another video. We're going to take a look at why it is important to use Blender alongside CATIA to process 3D scans. So over here I made use of the following 3D scan hand from Artec. As we can see, this will be available within PLY and WRL file format. And initially within Blender we had this converted to an STL that was later processed in CATIA. Now, within CATIA, I have created the automatic surface, the closed surface for the original hand. And afterwards, I wanted to add a thickness of 1 millimeter on the inside. And CATIA didn't manage to do that. But afterwards, I took the model. So I just had it open within Blender. I added the thickness over here. Even though over here, it will say that the thickness is set to 1 meter. Keep in mind that when the STL file is imported from Blender to CATIA, it will again be converted. So you will have to scale it 1000 times. So over here within Blender, as we can see, the thickness is set to 1 meter, but consider that to be just as 1 millimeter when we're going to take the model back. And as you can see over here within CATIA, I still have this on not responding, even though I managed to process everything. And later on, I converted the 3D scan to a part design part and added the cut over here. Later, I wanted to move the resulting body over here, and that was still linked to the other one. So I should have unlinked that and just pasted the result, and then I would be able to move it freely. But right now, CATIA is still stuck. This is one of the drawbacks of CATIA. Within Blender, you can much more rapidly copy and rotate, and they will all, let's say, be individual. While in CATIA, if it has been created starting from a 3D scan, a surface, if you don't break that link between those two, it will be almost impossible. Okay, so now I encourage you to check the full workflow presented within the video. And also, let me know if you have any questions regarding this workflow, or if you have any comments to add regarding this. So that's it. Enjoy the video.